Hi everyone and welcome to Heart Matters. It's such a joy to come to you each week and share in the good things that our God has done. He's so worthy of our praise, and sharing these episodes with you is just one way we can give him that praise. In this show, we'll hear from a gentleman that found himself in an unsettling situation. Listen in as Willis Penny from Middle Arm shares the story of being lost in the woods in the fall of 2022. And trust me, this man has no shortage of faith in his God. Also joining us as today's musical guests, we're so happy to welcome Aaron Collins to the Heart Matters stage. We truly hope that this show is a blessing to you today. Matters will return in just a moment.
Scott's Transport Limited is a family-owned and operated full transportation company located in beautiful Deer Lake. In business for over 25 years and with a fleet of modern equipment and dedicated team, we service the growing needs of businesses from Newfoundland and Labrador to Ontario and locations in between. If it matters to you, it matters to us. Closed captioning provided by Terry's Tents, in business for 30 years providing canvas fabrication, printing, embroidery, craft supplies, and more, located in Happy Valley, Goose Bay.
My name is Willis Penny, and I belong to Middle Arm, and I have my wife, I love her with all my heart, and there's, I got two boys and three girls. I've been in Middle Arm over 50 years. God have been so good to me. I lost my mom when I was only 5 years old, and Jesus is everything to me in life. I worked in the woods. And I had my own skidder then. I worked with the company for over 20 years, and I was a skidder operator. And then we got laid off. Me and my buddy bought one between us, and I was the operator. And I was in cotton, and my back gave out. Well, to say the story quick, I had three back surgeries. I had a hard time going, but the people in Middle Arm was just so good to me, everyone. It's just unspeakable. Would their finance, whatever it was. I thought I was going to lose everything I had, but everything, it all came together, and God works in mysterious ways. I never really went to go berry picking. I went in because the time was open for shooting grouse. And I never said to the wife, she just thought I was gone into the beer stand. And I took the bucket and I said, I'm going up on the ridge and see, can I see our grouse for a ride on my quad? And I went up and went on 9 or 10 kilometers, and I said to myself, I'm going up and pick a few berries. Where me and Dean Robinson used to pick the berries up on the burnover. And that was getting late then, that was after 2 o'clock. And I went up picking berries, and I picked a few berries here and there and picked a few. And this evening I looked at my watch and it was 5:30. And I sat down on a stump. I had some water there and I eat the bar I had and had the stump, and I said, I mean a long ways, a nice ways. And I started walking and I said, I should strike the road to the lookout. And I walked on and walked on, never struck the road. So then I walked back. I said, I got to go to the southwest. Walk back the other way. See, can I get strike the road? And never struck the road. So then my legs start to give out, my knee. And I dodged on and I went too far. And then I never come back the right way to the bike because everything was growing up so much, you know. It's very easy. I always says, I don't get lost, I got astray. And I said, well, that's it. There's nothing I can do. I'm going to be in the woods all night. And as darkness started to come in then, you know, around 7:30 was really dark. And I broke off boughs up on a, found a dry bank under a tree and broke off boughs. And when I got bowels enough broke down, I lid down for a while and relaxed and said, oh, Lord, why did I do this? Why did I do this? You know, I was so frustrated with my own self. And I said, Lord, I don't care about dying. I don't care if I dies now. I was really thinking about my family. And I said, not only my family, but my wife have phoned Dean now. That's my buddy. And I said, everyone is on the look for me. And there's I down here by the pond. I said, why did I come down here? If I'd have stayed up in the burnover, it would have been much better. I said, I'm sure Urbanity will have the chopper out. All over Bayvert, Cornerbrook, they even sent out from Cornerbrook and asked my son-in-law, Herb, do you want us to bring some quads out? Or, and Pastor Garandy was carrying food in that day, all, you know, people going in with food for the people that was looking for me. And I said, Lord, I don't know what I can do. I can do nothing, only just pray to you, and then pray everything will be okay. I was talking to Jesus all night. I was singing a lot. What a mighty God we serve. Heaven and earth adore him. Angels bow before him. What a mighty God we serve. I should sense the presence of God so wonderful. And in the woods, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He lighteth me beside the still waters. Yea, though I walk through the valley, and the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff that comfort me. Thou prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemy. The Bible says, be calm and still, to know that I am God. The three J's was with me that night, and the three J's stayed there all night with me, and they was right alongside of me, stayed there all in the little bush all night. And in as the night went by, I got cold so many times. Then I broke off a lot of boughs, and when I lie down, I'd cover myself up with bed boughs like a blanket for to keep the heat in. And I don't know if I went to sleep or I slumbered, you know, and then I wouldn't let myself get too cold. When I'd get cold, I'd get up again. And as the night went on, every hour or so, or hour and a half, I was up beating myself because I only had on my jacket and just my shirt like I got on now, not just my shirt on the jacket, you know. And in the morning, it was a hard going. Around 4 o'clock, we had a frost, and it was really, really cold. And the beautiful stars were shining from the sky, blistering. I never got up till it really got daylight. And when I got up, I knew I wasn't going to get far. My leg was still paining a lot. I had a lot of pain in my leg. And when it got daylight, I just start to walk to the pond, to a open, like a open place on the pond, like what I call would be a good place for them to see me. Because I said within my mind, I said, I'm sure Urbanity will have the chopper out. And quarter to eight, when I was walking across, I heard the chopper. And I was waving the stick and waving it, and saying, oh, praise the Lord, he sees me. And the chopper went back and forth. Everything faded away then for the day for a while, because the chopper got to go past Springville for a fuel up. A while after then, I was just trying to get where I want to get, and I got over to the bank. And I got over to the bank around probably 2:30 where I want to get. And I said, Lord, I can't do no more. This is it, Lord. And I repeat the song we used to sing in church. Sun is sinking low, a few more days and I must go. I said, not a few more hours, but a few more hours and Will Penny must go to meet the deeds that he have done. Well, where will be no sitting sun. And I just slid back in a slumber, and I thought I heard something. And I got up and shook myself, and there was the chopper going across to Nodis, and he turned around and came back. He flit along, and I heard Jonah, my grandson, say, "I sees Pop." And he went down the pond, whoosh, and came back where I was to, and Om put the water in on me and saying, "Stay there, stay there." And I was led back on the bank saying, "Praise God, praise God, they got me found." I heard someone saying, "Uncle Will, we got you alive. Praise God, we got you alive." And I called it my two angels. This was the other two boys coming towards me with their arms open like an angel. The hamlet said to me when they carried me up and took me to the hamlets, like after I got aboard the chopper, you know, and carried me up, and he said, "Mr. Penny, we're taking you up to middle arm now." I said, "Yeah, do whatever you got to do. I'm okay now. I'm with somebody. I'm found." And they said, "We're going to carry you into the machine now to examine you." I said, "Carry me in. I can walk." And then they just give me a hug and laugh. And then he examined me. He said, "You're healthier than what I am." And then they give me another hug. And the next day, it was unbelievable. The people that I had visiting me. It meant everything. There's just a job to express it all. I'm not good. There's no goodness in me. I'm only a sinner saved by the grace of God. God don't look at the little silly things in our heart. God looks at the love that we got formed in our heart. If I had to live another 80 years, I'd still live it for Jesus and try to do more. I give the glory to Jesus.
Heart Matters is all about people, especially you, our viewers. That's why we love hearing from you. Maybe you have a suggestion for an upcoming show. Perhaps you know of someone who has a story to tell or a song to sing that could be a blessing to all of us. We also love getting feedback from you guys. Simply send us a message letting us know how something you've seen on this show has impacted you. And as always, if you follow us on social media, you can keep up to date on upcoming episodes and events. Still to come on today's show, The Bottom Line with Mike Freak, and more music from Aaron Collins, when Heart Matters returns.
From envelopes to tractor trailer loads, Dooley's Trucking caters to all your shipping needs. Capable of meeting all your shipping requirements throughout Newfoundland, Dooley's Trucking is your choice for fast and efficient delivery. Ship with the best. Ship Dooley's.
RE/MAX would like to say thank you for allowing us to be a part of the most important transaction of your life. Our mandate is giving back to the communities that serve us. We will be honored to help you with your next move. Call any of our offices today and let one of our RE/MAX agents go to work for you.
My name is Brandon. I'm the owner here at Gander Appliance and Furniture. We sell a wide variety of appliances and furniture, including Canadian-made Decorest, Ashley Furniture, Samsung, as well as Whirlpool.
Last month, the island portion of our province was hammered with freezing rain, and it was described as the Battle of the Air Masses. You had a southerly tropical mass moving up and meeting a northerly cold mass coming down and meeting directly over Atlantic Canada, and it was the perfect recipe for ice and freezing rain. And it wasn't your typical January Newfoundland weather. Throughout most portions of the island, especially central to the west coast, people and communities prepared for what was forecasted. And this slow-moving system wreaked havoc on the province for a couple of days. And it was not only dangerous to travel on the highways, but the amount of ice caused damage to power lines, trees, and buildings, and causing periodic power outages across the province. And it was one of those weekends that, you know, you just wanted to stay inside and lock the doors and eat potato chips and wait it out. And it didn't take long for ice to begin to build up on the trees. And in our backyard, the big birch tree was bent over right onto the roof of the shed, and pieces of branches were scattered all over the back garden. And as I was sitting in my office and looking out the window that Monday morning at all the trees across the road, they were heavy with ice, and many of them were bent over by the sheer weight of the ice buildup. And apart from the damage that it caused, it actually looked pretty amazing. I mean, the trees looked beautiful as the light glistened off of them, and they looked almost magical, like something from another world. And as I looked at the trees, the thought came to me that this is what so many people feel like. So many people have gone through so many storms, and they've had to endure so much, and it weighs heavy on them. The pressure of their circumstances have built up over time, and they are so heavy and burdened down by the things of life. And those trees, for many, are a perfect picture of how they look and feel on the inside. You see, Jesus knows exactly what each of us are facing. He knows and sees the weight of each one of us and what we carry. Jesus said this in the Bible to his listeners. He said, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." Rest. What a wonderful word and a beautiful promise for everyone. You know, the day that I was looking at the trees and thinking about this today, we had to move fast to record it because the sun was coming. And when the sun came, it didn't take long for the ice to disappear and for the trees to get back into their upright position again. The bottom line is this today. The Son of God has come to shine on all those who are weary and tired. And regardless of what is weighing you down today, there is hope and there is rest for you.
You're the resurrection that we've waited for. Buried the night, and you came with the morning. You're the King of heaven, the praise is yours. The longer the choir, the louder the chorus. Thirst for you, the dry and the barren. You're the sun that's shining. You restore my soul. The deeper you call us, oh, the deeper we'll go. We will sing a new song, 'cause death is dead and gone with the winter. We will sing a new song. Let hallelujahs flow like a river. We're coming back to life, reaching towards the light. Your love is like springtime. And the soil of my soul, and like a garden, and like a garden I will grow. Oh, I will grow. Oh, come tend the soil, come tend the soil of my soul. Like a garden, and like a garden I will grow. Oh, I will grow. Oh, I will grow. We will sing a new song, 'cause death is dead and gone with the winter. We will sing a new song. Let hallelujahs flow like a river. We're coming back to life, reaching towards the light. Your love is like springtime, like springtime.
Just like that last song talks about, when you decide to follow Jesus, it's a beautiful journey of pursuing that light and drawing closer to Him each day. Sure, some days we feel like we fall short, but still, we continue to reach toward that light. I want to thank Aaron and Willis for being our special guests today. These shows are only made special because of the wonderful people who graciously give of their time to encourage us all and give glory to God for what He has done. Well, that's all the time we have for now, but we invite you all back again next week.